Hey, what's up, guys? This is Johan, and I haven't seen you guys in about a week, haven't I? Alright, guys, so where have I been for an entire week? I've basically been working my butt off. I've been getting up at 6 or 5 in the morning and leaving the house at 6:30 just to make sure I get out to work early, and then I've been working about 13 hours or at least sitting in traffic for another hour after work, so 12 hours of work and then another hour, so 13 hours away from the house. And then I get home and I'm really tired, so I had a jump in the shower and head to sleep, or jump in the shower and I'm designing until 12 a.m. I'm a graphic designer by trade, so hence the glasses. I don't wear glasses on a daily basis, by the way. These are just these are called Gunner Optics. They are basically glasses that reflect the light, or at least diffuse the light on your eyes, so it doesn't put an entire strain on your eyes, and then you have to end up wearing glasses. So glasses to prevent you wearing glasses. Go figure. But these are the clear ones, because I am a graphic designer, so it prevents me from mixing up colors as well. So if you know, if you're a photographer and you take any pictures and you have any color shifts, so you have the right color corrections. I have the yellow ones as well. They work pretty well. If you know your colors, it doesn't matter which one you have, but I just prefer that using the clear ones. Anyways, that's enough of the graphic design stuff. So let's get into the tank updates and what's been going on with the main display. Here is the fish tank. So far, so good. Everything is cool. You know, nothing too crazy. I did do a little bit of re-aquascape. All the fish are doing okay. There's a little bit of re-aquascape here where I changed the rocks that was wrong and make it look something more eye-pleasing, because this side of the tank has always been just a pile of rocks. But I rearranged the corals a little bit. There's a Pavona here, the Gornea pole right there, some mushroom corals here. I have a little bit of Salophora. That blue Sympodium coral that I showed you guys earlier back there, some more mushrooms. And I found out something on this mushroom rock that I have here. I actually have a tiny little clam on that rock, but it's on the back side, so I'll throw a clip in to show you guys what it looks like. Another update that is going on with this tank is I put the Melanaris wrasse in and it is still sleeping. It doesn't get up till about 12:45 or so in the afternoon, almost 1 o'clock. So that's when the lights come on. So the lights, there's like another hour till the lights come on. So it doesn't come on till then. So this tank is pretty much empty. There's no fish in here at all. The lawnmower Blenny that was in this tank actually passed away. If you guys are following me on Instagram, you will see that I had something's up. There's some kind of power that's going on in this tank. I'm not sure what it is, but I'll put a clip in so you guys can see what I'm talking about. And whilst we're talking, I don't know what this is right here. Whatever this is, it won't focus, but it looks like some kind of snail on the inside. So I have some kind of, oh yeah, it's a baby snail. Wow. So something is definitely happening in this tank, but the corals are okay. But oddly enough, the normal blend is died because he always hangs up on at the top right here. At sleep at night, so I'm guessing whatever electrical failure it is got to him. But the odd thing is, I don't think it's electrical any pump, because no matter what I plug in, I get that electrical feedback from my foreign voltage detector. And the odd thing too, I don't get the same foreign voltage from the other tanks, like the quarantine is down here. But what I do get is I might get a slight shock if I have a cut on my finger. I might get a slight shock from all three tanks. So that makes me think it's not a defective pump. I'm thinking there's something in the wiring inside the walls that something's messed up. I'm not an electrician by trade. I did get certified for electricity a long time ago, so I'm not 100% sure of that. So if anybody's an electrician down in the comments, let me know. So with that electrical issue that I was having, or have yet to track down which, if it's the actual device or if it's something in the wall, I did order a one of those grounding probes, actually three grounding probes, but unfortunately I didn't get it. I've been having this odd problem of ordering things and then not getting them. At first I thought maybe, you know, it was getting delivered and then somebody's taking it, stealing it or something, because, you know, that's how the world is now. You actually see people uploading videos of people stealing stuff off of people's doorsteps. But the grounding probe kind of made me wonder, and the Bionic stuff as well. I don't think it's anybody stealing stuff in my neighborhood. I think it's more or less the people who are shipping. Like, for example, the Bionic stuff, the boxes, so big, which I'll show you. And it doesn't fit in the mailbox, but it said it was left in the mailbox. And then also the next thing was those grounding probes. I saw when the guy pulled up to deliver them, he went in the back to look for them and he didn't have them, and then he drove off. Then I was emailing Amazon about at 10 o'clock saying that I didn't get my stuff, and then it updated me saying my stuff was delivered at 10:09 p.m. and UPS doesn't deliver at that time. But anyways, I was refunded by Amazon, so I have to reorder the grounding probe just to take care of that electrical issue, and then until I track down what it is so I don't shock any more fish or shock myself. All right, so that's update with those the tanks and what's going on right now. The quarantine is empty and has been since, well, 3 days or 4 days ago. After that pump that killed most of the fish in, I drained all the water, took everything out, and I also got another lawnmower blending, which is inside the main display. He already went for his quarantine. His quarantine was really short because the person I got them from had the fish in quarantine already, and it was in copper, and I took it to my tank, made sure there was quarantine in and there was no ick or no parasite. So he stayed in there for about a month, and now he usually sleeps right in this cave right here. All right, so let's get into the other updates and what I'm going to be preparing for next week, or at least this coming weeks. So as soon as I turned off the camera to go show you guys the other updates, the Melanaris rash just came out. He doesn't sleep on this side, unless he starts sleeping on this side. I don't know, but he's over here. He's pretty shy because he's been in here for 3 days today, well, 2.5 days. He'll be 3 days in 5 hours. So anyways, 2.5 days he's been in this tank. And the odd thing enough, I thought that when he got in here that he would probably get bullied by the cleaner ass, but together in like almost like a spiral. So if they would do it, I'll get a clip on it and I'll show it to you guys. But the Emperor Angel, he's just being a butthole right now. He was bullying it, chasing it all over the tank. I was thinking of taking out the Emperor Angel, but he calmed down after 4 hours. So at least, you know, he calmed down. And then the hippo tang joined in, and then it hasn't been any other aggression after that. So just the hippo tang and the Emperor Angel, and those are the two bosses of the tank that goes after it. Anyways, back to another update. All right, so the updates that are coming are right on the table behind you guys, so let's get into it. All right, so what we have here is just my little makeshift workstation in my living room. So I have my audio going right here. So I have my live rock here. I've been planning this video for a long time, but I just keep either forgetting or getting too busy to do it. As far as how to aquascape, I have like 3 or 4 pieces of live rock that's in here, and that's gonna go into this 10-gallon tank that's right here. Just for quickly aquascape, I'm not gonna set up any other tank. I'm only allowed 2 tanks. I'm actually only allowed 1, but I snuck one in for the nano challenge, and wifey was like, okay, sure, whatever. The next thing, here are my other gunners that I was talking about earlier. These are the yellow ones. Here are my other the update. So if you guys remember, I ordered some stuff from saltwatercrims.com. Something didn't come. The Bionic, my three-part dosing. After a few days of going back and forth and trying to track down the package, we couldn't find it. Couldn't find it anywhere in the neighborhood. So they went ahead and sent me a box and replacement. So that's good. Odd thing though, if you guys see the size of this box, right? This doesn't fit in a mailbox. Anywhere in a mailbox, right? So they told, at least the person who delivered it said it was left in the mailbox. And my mailbox, I don't know what the size of your guys' mailbox is, but the regular mailbox is not that big. So that's just that. So because of this, I have I have to start testing my alkalinity and my alk, calcium and magnesium. So I have this test kit by Red Sea. I've always had this. I want to make sure it's still good. So I have to make sure it's not expired because I've had this over 2 years. Next thing, my snacks, don't mind these. These go good with editing, designing, or just relaxing, watching a movie. I love snacks. One of my light controllers, the wireless light controllers for the DIY lights I built, is actually something's up with it, stopped working. So I have these are the, I can't remember the name, I put the words right there, but these guys, I'm programming this one and this one to just control the lights temporarily until I get another wireless controller in. And then my salinity test, I have to do a video on this for my refractometer. So that's coming up. And then this one, I am still working on it. It's a Yulangu. I got that Yulangu camera slider I did a video of, and I pretty liked it. And then there is another one. This is basically a camera stabilizer. You put your camera on top and you basically, bright lights. So you basically have your camera on top here and it acts like a gimbal kinda. And I'm still trying to figure out how to work it before I could do a proper review of this. So that's the last video that's gonna be done. So that's pretty much most of the updates. Oh yeah, and then random roofing tips. I've missed 2 of those. So I got some glue over there and the pipe over there that for that video. Alright guys, so that pretty much wraps it up for this video. I'm gonna go ahead and start with the other videos for the updates as much as I can today, and get ready for that weather change for Wednesday. And also, if you guys are wondering what's up with my attire, why do I have Tinkerbell up on my head and on my pants? It's just something that my wife made for me. I like Tinkerbell. She is a DIY person and she makes you fly, and I'm a DIY person who loves flying. So you know, 2 things that goes hand in hand. But anyways guys, that is it for this video. If you guys like it, go and hit the like button down below, and also remember, subscribe. I'll catch you guys in the next one.